Hi, my name is Tom Wheat. I'm a principal scientist in the systems laboratory here at Waters. I would like to spend a few minutes with you discussing AutoBlend Plus technology and introducing the steps in using the software that makes this technology accessible. AutoBlend Plus technology is the use of a solvent management system capable of four-solvent blending to prepare and adjust chromatographic mobile phases using pure solvents and concentrated stocks. This functionality has been used for years in controlling protein separations, and it has proven valuable in many other separation modes. The newest implementation, associated with the ACQUITY UPLC H-class system family, adds a user interface that was requested by many chemists. The new enhancements make the functionality easier to use by expressing the chromatographic method in parameters that are most familiar to the biochemist. I would like to begin with some discussion of the underlying principles that make this technology valuable to users. Biological macromolecules are characterized by charged functional groups, and proteins in particular have large numbers of both positive and negative charges. These charges are sensitive to pH, so the properties of the molecules depend very much on the pH of the solution. Those properties, in turn, control the chromatographic behavior of the molecule. Since each protein has a unique charge distribution, adjustment of pH has been recognized as the most powerful variable for adjusting chromatographic selectivity. The preparation of buffers typically involves weighing salts and then titrating them to the particular pH with strong acid or base using a pH meter. Long ago, it became customary instead to prepare buffers from concentrated stocks of an acid and its salt or a base and its salt. Specified volumes are mixed and the pH is checked and adjusted using the meter. When pH is iteratively adjusted for the best separation, a pair of buffers at low and high ionic strength must be prepared for each experiment. When four-solvent pumps became available for HPLC, we found that we could simplify this process by using the pump to proportion on demand. We called this technique AutoBlend, using the four solvent lines as an acid, a base, a salt, and water. The pH of the separation could be adjusted from the software without preparing multiple pairs of buffers. This approach has proven popular and reliable for many years, but right from the first inception, users have wanted enhancements that would make the technology easier to use. Most especially, they wanted to program the instrument in pH and ionic strength, as opposed to percent A, percent B, and so on. As we began the development of the ACQUITY UPLC H-class biosystem, we took the opportunity to add the user interface for convenient use of the four-solvent blending as AutoBlend Plus technology. Let's go through the steps in using the interface. When we open the instrument method for programming the solvent management system, we find the familiar gradient table used for the ACQUITY UPLC H-class system. But notice the additional button labeled AutoBlend Plus. Click this button to move to the alternative method interface. The gradient table is now displayed with columns for pH and salt concentration. Those two values are entered by the user. And the rest of the gradient table is created by filling in the steps that are required. The pH curve and the salt curve are the traditional 11 Waters gradient curves. Separate and independent curves can be specified for pH and ionic strength. Both pH and ionic strength can change simultaneously. The free adjustment of these two parameters can be useful in optimizing the separation for a particular protein mixture. It is not obvious, however, from this table how the solvent management system derives the desired buffer and salt profile from the four solvent bottles that are available to it, where it must reliably deliver the correct proportions from each of the four lines. The software calculates the percentage flow from each reservoir based on the information associated with the buffer system available as a drop-down menu. When the buffer is selected, the screen displays the information about what is in each of the four reservoirs, as well as the intended total buffer concentration and the usable pH range. Let's look at how a buffer system is defined. The button next to the drop-down menu takes us to the buffer system editor. In this editor, we can enter the desired total buffer concentration, and we can specify the identity and concentration of the solutions in the four named reservoirs. These names are chosen from a drop-down list drawn from a library of defined buffers and salts. New solutions may be added by choosing New from the drop-down list. A new buffer name may then be entered along with the concentration at which it is prepared. The comment field is a convenient place to enter the exact recipe used to prepare the buffer. We select the four elements of the mobile phase: the acid, the base, the salt, and the aqueous. Note that at this point we are only defining those four names. They are not intrinsically associated with a particular physical solvent line. We'll return to that idea later. When we have chosen the names, we must define how the software should calculate the proportions. The salt concentration is straightforward, since we specify the concentration in the reservoir and the desired concentration with the gradient table. The information to calculate the proportions of acid and base can be provided in several ways. The simplest way to reach the desired pH is to provide the pK for the buffer pair in use. The required proportions are then calculated using the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. The pK values may be obtained from any number of public reference materials. If a formally measured pK for the desired buffer is not readily available, a good equivalent may be obtained by mixing equal molar proportions of the defined acid and base and diluting to the specified buffer concentration. The measured pH of this solution is the pK by definition. The Henderson-Hasselbalch equation provides a good approximation of the pH, but it is not perfectly accurate. The published pKs reflect the ionic strength of the measurement as well as the temperature. Further, true pH is based on activity, not concentration. While this may be corrected using the Debye-Huckel equation, the calculation is cumbersome and must include values that are difficult to obtain. The buffer system editor provides two convenient, practical approaches to providing a more accurate basis for calculating the pH. The first makes use of the same approach used above to approximate the pK by mixing the buffers and measuring the pH. If this single reference solution is made by mixing the equimolar proportions of acid and base and also adding the salt solution equal to the midpoint of the gradient, the measured pH can be used as the pK entry. The pH deviation across the ionic strength gradient should be less than 0.1 to 0.15 different from the true pH. A still more accurate basis for calculating the pH with correction for the ionic strength gradient is the use of the empirical table. Instead of choosing pK, select empirical table. Then, the user prepares a set of buffer samples based on the percentages that they enter in the table. The pH of each blend is measured with a pH meter, and the observed value is entered in the table. When a buffer system defined in this way is used as the basis of the gradient table, The calculation of proportions of acid and base is based on interpolation among the measured data points. We have found it convenient and sufficiently accurate to use a 9-point calibration corresponding to low, intermediate, and high salt concentrations at low, medium, and high pH values. The empirical table gives the most accurate delivered gradient because it automatically compensates for changes due to ionic strength as well as other variables such as temperature. We have considered how to create a buffer system that will be used to calculate the proportions of each solution to be delivered during the separation. Our last obligate task is the association of the defined acid, base, salt, and aqueous solutions with particular solvent lines and proportioning valves. From the main solvent manager instrument method, choose the solvents tab. The solution that is placed in each of the four solvent reservoirs is now selected from the dropdown. This function for assigning different physical reservoirs to the specified names becomes very important and valuable when the system is configured with a 6-port solvent select valve. This valve is always associated with the D reservoir. The D reservoir can then be used for various acids, bases, or salts. The specific D line is selected from the drop-down menu to the right of the solvent selection box. We have now described all the software functions that are associated with AutoBlend Plus technology as used in the ACQUITY UPLC H-Class biosystem. It should make it easier to develop and to execute optimal separation methods based on careful selection of the optimum pH for analysis of a particular sample. Please do not hesitate to contact us through your usual channels if you have any additional questions. Thank you.